Hello, Klaus from Duke Denver Film here. In today's video, we'll have a look at something a little bit different than usually. We are going to have a look at some new transition packs from Messias. They have three new packs and they did contact me and they did send them to me and asked me if I want to have a look at them. And of course, I want to do that. So in this video, we'll have a look at the first pack, which is the Wipe Move Transition Pack. And first off, in this video, I'll show you how to get the transitions into DaVinci Resolve 16 and then how to use them. So these are made specifically for DaVinci Resolve 16. They are easy to drop and to customize inside of Fusion. So we'll have a look at that right now. So let's have a look at the Wipe Move Transition Pack right now. Let's go have a look. Okay, so here we are in our project in DaVinci Resolve, and we're just going to click this little icon down here, and we're going to open up our projects. And we are going to import a project from the Messias pack, the Wipe Transition pack. We're going to import their project into DaVinci Resolve. So here we are. And then we are going to make sure that we have project or dynamic project switching enabled. So as you will see here, we have it enabled here in our project and in the Messias project. So we'll open the Messias project here, highlight the folders and then Control C. And then we're going up here and we're going to switch to our own project. And then we're just going to paste them in by pushing Control V. And first off, we'll just quickly relink all the offline media. Done. With the magic of editing. And the way these transition works is they're supposed to be drag and drop, kind of. So let's just zoom in a bit here. Whoops. Okay, let's go there. And I have here the transition. And we'll just move that so it's in between the clip. And then we'll select this and we'll go up to the clip and he will decompose the timeline and we'll just erase the two clips here. So now we have our transition. Pretty neat, I think. So it is actually possible if you go to the Fusion to go into the clips just by selecting here and go up to the inspector. And it is possible to actually change them in or modify them in any way you want. Or either you can invert the motion, you can shake size and shake speed as well. So you can do whatever you want here and change it. And then again, you can do change the angle if you want to do something different. Something like that. So it's just totally customizable and that's pretty darn neat, I think. So here we have the customized one I just did. In all honesty, I do like the other one more. So if you, for one reason, don't like what you did, it's super easy just to go back and reset everything in Fusion. So here we have a look at all the transitions in the pack. And of course, they are pretty stylized transitions. And I do think they work the best when they are changing the scene you're doing. And I'm not changing the scene that much in the stock footage I used here, but I do think they are pretty good and they are going to be helpful. Most likely they will fit very well into travel videos and stuff like that, where you are moving pretty fast from locations. Down in the description, there will be links to where to get them and more about Messias. I think I will link that down in the description, or you can visit the channel, their channel, so you can see more about this. So this was just the first very fast video about the Messias transitions, and more are coming up. There's two packs more, so I'll make two videos more about the next two packs they're doing. Hopefully you'll find this useful, and I will see you in the next video. Until next time.